box sculpture. Now, if you don't have cereal boxes or you would like to use something that's different colors, you're welcome to use all sorts of drink containers. I've got butter box, tissue box has lots of cool designs sometimes. So just work with a thin cardboard that you have around your house. So today we're going to get started off. If you want to, you can use glue or tape, but if you want a big challenge, definitely set those over to the side. But you are going to need scissors, probably a pencil, a cardboard, and then if you would like to pause this to see the shapes that are our basic shapes that you might want to use as a theme, you can do that now. Otherwise, you can go ahead and get started picking out the colors that you want to use and then getting started by choosing your shape. I started with triangles on this one, so I'm going to get to it. The easiest way to get a triangle is to get a square or rectangle cut out and then just draw a diagonal line from one corner to the opposite corner. Then you're going to cut along that line using your scissors. And just remembering scissor safety. Don't forget. We are going to use each side and make a small line, about a fourth of an inch, that's about the width of my pinky, to make a slit in the side where we would like to attach another piece. That way we have somewhere to fit it together. You can see my examples here are freestanding and don't need anything to hold them together, except for those slits. Now, looking at my one I have here, I think I'm going to need a new slit in it. So I'm going to use the slit I have here and first show you that if we take another piece, put a small line in it and cut it, then fitting our shapes together with that slit, wiggle through until they combine together and they overlap, and with just a little bit of twisting you should have them together without any glue or tape. Now to attach it to my other sculpture, I have been playing around with how to have this stand up, and I think I like this way as much as the others. But if I decide I want to add this piece on here, that is going to change how my sculpture looks and how it is going to stand once they are together. Now, so I can stand at different angles, and I can almost hit my 6-inch challenge. That 12-inch challenge would be up above my paper, because this is 11-inch paper, so I would have to really do some work to get it to there. But my 6-inch is just a little below my 8.5-inch side of my paper, so I don't have far to go with that one. If I wanted to use bigger pieces, bigger triangles, I could, but if I am more into the design part of it and how it looks with my shapes and how I like it to look, then I might add some smaller pieces as well. But that is totally up to you. Make sure you are using your design process where you build it, test it, improve it, and try again. I hope you're enjoying this.